This is called Waterfall.
Hey, we're Crownlands.
And you're tuned in to Once to Watch Northside Sessions.
I watch you and watch you lay down. Through the hollow city of sorrow. And I know. I feel like a wolf in darkness. I feel like the Amazon.
It's connected to the history of Canada and its mistreatment of Indigenous people. And it's sort of our way of reclaiming it by calling ourselves Crownlands.
I'm Mi'kmaq, which is a tribe from Nova Scotia, so it's a personal connection for me.
Yeah.
Since it's my heritage, I feel like it's my responsibility and my duty to, you know, to share this message on a platform.
Yeah, if people are paying attention to you, you may as well say something that means something to you. And so the reason why we make music with the message is because we have something to say, and this is the best way to say it.
Yeah, everything's political when you get down to it.
Especially politics.
Well, with our song Mountain, I feel that I have to kind of get into a specific headspace, and that talks about like the mistreatment of Indigenous people in the time of residential schools and historically in the past. So I have to kind of like reach into some emotional space and channel that. I just get into it. It's something that you can't really describe. It's something that you feel on stage and the energy of the show.
Yeah, it's hard because you're in the moment when you're on stage and you're not really thinking about reflecting on these things, but you almost have to when you're playing something like the song Mountain. You have to kind of get into that certain headspace for sure. But touring with Jack White was the best. It was an absolute dream come true. He kind of paved the way of what it meant to be a rock duo in the modern age.
Absolutely.
And we already owed so much to Jack and the White Stripes before we even toured with him, and now it's just compounded of the fact that he was willing to, him and his team were willing to give us a shot and play stadiums.
Yeah,
and it was,
and Yeah. And not only that, he was a really nice person, yeah. and he treated us so well. Him and his crew were unbelievable. Yeah. So it was a great experience all yeah. around, playing the biggest shows of our lives.
It's magical when you're singing a song and like 5,000 people sing it back to you. Like that's kind of the most magical part
yeah,
of it all.
Because
sure.
they had never heard of it before.
Yeah, so
they,
if people are willing to like latch onto it that quickly, you know you're doing something right.
Yeah, and I think in that atmosphere, people are more willing to participate in things like that, whereas in a small club, maybe people don't want to be the first to do it or anything. But since there's yeah. so many people, I think people are more inclined to contributing.
We've basically toured with all of our heroes this year. We started out opening up for Coed and Cambria and Protest the Hero. I'm originally from Whitby, and so I looked up to Protest my entire life. Mm-hmm. And then we got off that tour and opened up for Primus, and Les Claypool and his gang are legends and, you know,
yeah.
huge impact on us musically.
Absolutely, yeah.
And then, you know, to go from that to
right into,
the, you yeah. know, the guy, you know, you don't get much better than that. So.
I pull inspiration from many people for different things because I sing and I play drums. So for drumming, it's definitely like Neil Peart from Rush and Danny Carey and Bill Bruford and like weird prog drummers and stuff. But for singing, I'm really inspired by Michael Jackson and Freddie Mercury and Robert Plant, just like big singers. And Kev, you got a lot of cool inspirations that are less known.
For guitar, I do a lot of open tunings and finger picking. So there's an Australian guitar player named John Butler, and he's been like a huge influence on me. Same thing with like Lindsey Buckingham and Mark Knopfler, like the great finger pickers. Geddy Lee's a huge inspiration for his multitasking. It's like I'm stuck playing bass, guitar, and keyboards all at the same time. Mm-hmm. So I've got a contraption where I can play keyboards with my feet. And Geddy was one of the first guys that really pioneered that back in the 70s. So I try and borrow as much of that without, without stealing it too much. So that's what. To define success as an artist, I think, like Bob Dylan said it the best, his success is getting up in the morning and going to sleep at night, and in between you do what you want to do and mm-hmm. just create whatever you want to create. And that's what we're trying to do, is just
yeah.
get to a place where we're able just to get together and create what we need to
whenever,
on a consistent
yeah,
basis.
Whenever we like, and just that in and of itself is fulfilling enough to be success.